riding a mini bike and chasing a miniature pony. Drag queens were on TikTok. Opera singers were on TikTok. The Washington Post was on TikTok. Dogs I follow on Instagram were on TikTok. Most important, the self-made celebrities of Generation Z were on TikTok. A cohort of people in their teens and early 20s who have spent a decade filming themselves with a front-facing camera and meticulously filming their understanding of what their peers will respond to when they do it for. I said a new name for myself. That's her new name. She's from Tokyo, Canada, and likes to stay up with listening to music and writing. Marcella is Jewish, and she and her brothers were homeschooled. Not long before she made her video, her family had stopped at a base to renew their military IDs. One of her brothers glanced at her new ID and joked, accurately, that she looked like Anne Frank. For respondents, Marcella was as earnest and thoughtful as the video had seemed to look. She understood that it would seem offensive out of context, a context that was invisible to nearly everyone who saw it, and she was sanguine about the end messages that she received. TikTok, like the rest of the world, was a mixed bag, she thought, with bad ideas and cruelty and awareness. With so much creative potential. Its aerobic sensibility was perfectly suited for people her age, and so was its industrial strength ability to turn non-famous people into famous ones, even if only temporarily, even when they were miles away. Marcella had accepted the fact that she was around the room, and not an entirely foreign one. Her generation had grown up on YouTube, she knew. Watching ordinary kids become millionaires by turning on laptop cameras in their bedrooms and talking about stuff they like. The videos that I've been seeing, chaotic and sincere and nihilistic and very short, were the natural expressions of kids who had smartphones since they were in middle school or elementary school. TikTok, Marcella explained, was a sudden reaction to and an absurdist escape from the mass amounts of media we are exposed to every little day. TikTok has been downloaded more than 1 million times since its launch in 2017, and reportedly more monthly users than Twitter or Snapchat. Like those apps, it's free and peppered with advertising. I downloaded TikTok in May, adding its neon array of app icons on my phone. TikTok's parent company, ByteDance, is based in China, which in recent years has invested heavily and made major advances in artificial intelligence. After a $3 billion investment from the Japanese conglomerate SoftBank last fall, ByteDance was valued at more than $75 billion, the highest valuation for any startup in the world. I opened the app, and I saw a 3-foot-tall woman making her microwave door squeak to the melody of Yeah by Usher, and then a dental hygienist and her patient dancing to Baby Shark. A teenage girl blew up a bunch of balloons that spelled pussy to the tune of a jazz song from the beloved soundtrack of the anime series Cowboy Bebop. Young white people lip-synced to audio of non-white people in ways that ranged from innocently racist to overtly racist. A kid sprayed shaving cream into a frog and stepped into it so that shaving cream squirted out of the hole. In 5 minutes, the app has sandblasted my cognitive matter with 20 TikToks that had the legibility and logic of a narcoleptic dream. TikTok is available in 150 markets. Its videos are typically built around music, so language tends not to pose a significant barrier. And few of the videos have anything to do with the news, so they don't easily become dated. The company is reportedly focusing its growth efforts on the US, Japan, and India, which is its biggest market. Smartphone use in the country has swelled, and TikTok now has 200 million users there. ByteDance often hacks its way into a market, aggressively courting influencers on other social media networks and spending huge amounts on advertising, much of which runs on competing platforms. Coffee Chan, a general partner at Andreessen Horowitz, told me that investors normally look for organic growth in social apps. ByteDance has been innovative, she said, in its ability and willingness to spend its way to big numbers. One former TikTok employee I spoke to was troubled by the company's methods. On Instagram, they run ads with clickbait images and open gas room over a sexy image of a young teen girl. And it wouldn't matter if Instagram uses flash-free images, as long as the ad got a lot of engagement first. In April, the Indian government briefly banned TikTok, citing concerns that it was exposing users to pornography and sexual predation. At least three people in India have died from injuries sustained while creating TikToks, posing with a pistol, hanging out on train tracks, trying to put three people on a moving bike. In court, ByteDance insisted that it was losing $500,000 a day from the ban. The company announced plans to hire more local content moderators and to invest $1 billion in India during the next 3 years. The ban was lifted, and the company launched a campaign. Every day, three remedies.
Wait, can you keep it playing?
You want to listen to it?
Yeah.
It doesn't ask you to tell it who you know. In the future, according to ByteDance, large-scale AI models will determine your personalized information claims, as the website for the company's research lab declares. The app provides a discover page with an index of trending hashtags and a for you feed, which is personalized, if that's the way, by a machine learning system that analyzes each video and so that it can serve a continually refined, never-ending stream of TikToks optimized to hold your attention. In the terminology of TikTok, humans will put on that to make good content. And good content is anything that is shared, replicated, and built upon. In essence, the platform is an enormous meme factory, compressing the world into pellets of virality and dispensing those pellets until you get full or fall asleep. ByteDance has more than a dozen products, a number of which depend on AI recommendation engines. These platforms collect data that the company aggregates and uses to refine its algorithms, which the company then uses to refine its platforms. This key platform, called the virtuous cycle of AI, is what each platform has experiences in unity. Its research into computer vision, a process that involves extracting and classifying visual information. On the website of its research lab, the company lists short video recommendations as one of the applications of the computer vision technology. Although TikTok's algorithm likely relies in part, as other systems do, on user history and video engagement patterns, the app seems remarkably attuned to replacing
Yeah.
Orders you dinner by watching you look at food. After I had watched TikTok on and off for a couple of days, the racist insects disappeared from the food. I started to see a lot of videos of fat dogs, teenagers playing pranks on their teachers, retail workers making lemonade from the lemons and beans.
A little flap.
I still sometimes saw them at the food. People with horror faces popping into my frame, or 14-year-old. Michigan from 1983. But global warming track label, oh no, 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 no.
Going to be too pretty.
On YouTube and Twitter and Instagram, recommendation algorithms have been making us feel individually catered to while bending our selfhood into shapes. Favorites, whatever will hold people's eyes.